Hello, listeners and viewers. Welcome to Kaduna State Ministry of Education Radio and TV e-learning program designed for our SS3 and other students staying at home due to the coronavirus pandemic. The present administration, under the able leadership of His Excellency, Malam Nasir Ahmed El-Rufai, is positioned, as always, to ensure that under his leadership, our students are not left behind in all areas of human endeavors, especially education. Kaduna State is the center of learning. Therefore, we want to ensure that our students excel in their forthcoming examinations and beyond. Students and other learners at home are given this opportunity in order to continue learning, as education is a continuous process. Different subjects will be taught in this program to assist students to perform excellently in the forthcoming senior school certificate examination being conducted by NECO and WAEC as soon as schools reopen. Teachers making presentations will always provide their names and phone numbers during each presentation, and they can be contacted for questions, further explanations, and/or clarifications. The following numbers and contacts can also be reached for expression of any concern or observation: 090-865-00545 or 080-383-62072. Our website is www.education.kdsg.gov.ng. Our email, education@kdsg.gov.ng or education.kdsg@gmail.com. Our YouTube channel, Ministry of Education, Kaduna State. Our Twitter handle, @Kaduna_MOE. Or our Facebook page, Ministry of Education, Kaduna State. Stay safe, stay at home, and learn well. Thank you, happy listening and happy viewing.
Hello, learners. You are welcome to yet another e-learning. My name is Mr. Obi Ifeanyi, and I'm here to take you on economics. In economics today, we are going to look at a very important topic. This topic is what is happening everywhere now. With this coronavirus and the lockdown everywhere, we have what we call inflation. So inflation is what we are going to look at today. When we say inflation, what is inflation? Before we define inflation, let us run down on what we have today. We have to look at inflation, we look at measurement of inflation, look at types of inflation, causes of inflation, how to control inflation, and the possibly economic effects of inflation. Inflation, definition of inflation. How do you define inflation as a student and a normal student? Inflation may be defined as the persistent or continuous rise in the prices of goods and services. Persistent rise. When prices of goods and services are going up, you go to the market today, you do what? You go and buy garri. A cup of garri is how much? 50 naira. The next 2 days, you go to buy another cup of garri. They tell you it's 60 naira. Say, oh, I bought it the other day, 50. They say it has increased. After the next 3 days, you go to market again. I want a cup of garri. They will tell you it's 100 naira. That is inflation. Persistent rise in the prices of goods and their services. It is also like that today. A very good example is pure water. Pure water is moving. Formerly, you get pure water 5 naira. A bag, how much? 70 naira, 80 naira. Today, a bag of pure water is how much? Just within a space of not even up to 1 month, a bag of pure water sells for 120 naira. That is from the factory. Why retailers sell for 150 naira? That is inflation. So inflation is the persistent rise in the prices of goods and their services. Inflation can be measured in the following ways. One is GDP index. GDP is gross domestic product. How do you measure GDP? You say that this measures the total value of goods and services that are produced in a country at a particular period of time. So you have to measure the total value, the value of the goods that are produced in that particular country at a given period of time. The second point is a wholesale index. How do you use wholesale index to measure inflation? What is wholesale index, wholesale price index? It measures the price of inputs used in the production of goods like equipments, machines, raw materials which their increase in their prices will affect the goods. Once the prices of this equipment starts rising, the equipment that are used in production, remember, both the cost of these equipment and the raw materials, all of them are put together and give you the price of the product. If there is increase in the price of these equipment and raw materials, then there will be increase in the prices of goods and their services. Just like there is decrease in the price of fuel and the production of petroleum products, you have now seen that the federal government have reduced the price of fuel from 145 to 125 to signify the reduction in the price. It shows that the cost of producing the fuel is now lower. So that is what you get in a wholesale price index. Once the prices of equipment and machines and raw materials used in production is getting high, what you get is that the price will also continue to increase. The third one is a consumer price index. What is consumer price index? This is the main determinant of a country's level of inflation because it measures the price of consumer goods. Consumer price index measures the price of consumer goods. Just as I've told you about pure water, it's a consumer good. Just as I've told you about garri, you know, all these consumer goods, because people buy it day by day and at every period of time. So once consumer products or consumer goods and services start increasing, it's a very good measurement of a country's inflation. Types of inflation. We are going to look at these two types of inflation. We have ordinary inflation and persistent inflation. What is ordinary inflation? Ordinary inflation is the gradual or intermittent rise in the prices of goods and services caused by an increase in the volume of money in circulation. Gradual. Once the volume of money in circulation in a country increases a little, you know, definitely there will be increase in the prices of goods and their services. That when it is gradual, we call it ordinary. Then we now go to the second one, which is persistent inflation. What is persistent inflation? As the name implies, persistent. It is a continuous rise in the prices of goods and services, resulting in a large volume of money in circulation, far more than the available goods and services in the country. When the volume of money in circulation in the country rises without lowering, the volume of money has risen without a corresponding rise in the production of goods and services to sustain the money that is available, then there must be inflation. But where the rise as the money in circulation is rising, there is adequate provision or production of goods and services in order to equate the inflation. So when we are talking about persistent inflation, we are talking about the continuous rise in the price of goods and services resulting as a result of large money in circulation. When there is large money pumped into the economy, you are bound to have a persistent inflation. Persistent inflation can be divided into the following. One is demand pull inflation. Demand pull inflation. What is demand pull inflation? This is caused when demand for goods and services is higher than the supply, and it is caused by increase in wages and their salaries. Demand pull. When there is increase in wages and salaries, there will be higher demand for goods and services. For example, a family that usually every month when they pay salary, you go to purchase a crate of egg. Then he was receiving 30,000. By the time he started receiving 50,000-60,000, he started buying two crates of egg. So definitely, the demand pull inflation just refers to its cost when there is a higher increase in salaries and their wages. So we define it as increase in the demand of goods and services, which is caused by high demand of goods and their services. When there is high demand of goods and services, then we say that it is demand pull, because when the demand is higher, when the demand is very high, caused by, because you have your salary has been increased, that one salary has, so, and we all push to the market at the same time. Maybe as we go to the market at the same time, because we are buying one crate of egg, the people selling may have about 50 crates of egg. But now we are now buying two crates of egg, which means only about 10 or 20 will get it. No longer about 50 people can get it. Thereby, by the time we use that our money to scramble for that available goods and services, it will now force the price of those eggs to go up. That is demand pull inflation. Now, the second one is a cost pull inflation. Cost. What is cost pull inflation? This is when the rise in the prices of goods and services is caused by an increase in the cost of production. Cost of production, just it could be in form of increase in the cost of machinery, it could be in the as a result of increase in raw materials that are used in the production of the product. For example, when you need to produce bread, you need to buy butter, you need to buy wheat or flour and other kind of sugar. So a rise in the price of sugar can equally affect the price of that bread. A rise in the price of wheat that you use in producing your bread will affect, will cause a rise in the final production of the bread itself. And the rise in the price of butter will equally affect the price of that bread. So that is cost pull inflation, when there is a rise in the prices of goods and services caused by increase in the cost of production. We go to number three, which is hyper or galloping inflation. Hyper or galloping inflation. Hyper or galloping inflation occurs when prices of goods and services skyrocket to an unimaginable height. And it may be caused by war or deficit budget. When there is war, people no longer think about production of goods and services. People are busy trying to save their heads. Nobody goes to the farm, nobody goes to the factory to produce this and that. People are steady looking for how to save their heads, in fact, to be alive. It is when you are alive that you think of how to produce or how to get money. So during that time, because there is no longer, or production is no longer adequate, people now scramble for that little available goods and services, which definitely will force the prices to go very high, thereby causing inflation. Let us look actually at the causes of inflation. There are various causes of inflation. There are about 10 of them. We have to mention them before we have to list them before we start discussing them. One is when demand is greater than supply. The second one is when decrease in production. The third one is increase in the cost of production. Four, war. Five, monopoly. Six, hoarding. Seven, poor storage facilities. Eight, deficit budget. Nine, reduction in imports, and 10, natural disaster. I have told you this, listed all this for you. In my usual way, when you see all this in your examination, you are even question number one, what is inflation? That is 1A, and 1B says state the causes of inflation. I are expected to define inflation, that is 1A. Then when coming to these causes of inflation, you are expected to do what? List and explain any four. There are 10. This 10 is for your own understanding. The way you understand number 9 may not be the way you understand number 2. So out of these 10, look for four that you know very well and explain them. But if you have it in your examination, just question number 1. Examine the causes of inflation or identify the causes of inflation, you are expected to list 5 and explain the 5. Don't just list them and go away. No, you must list them and explain them. When it is only one question that do not have B, A or B. If it is just one question, you are expected to list any from this 10. Pick any 5 that you like and do what? And then list them and explain it. But if it is A, define inflation, why B is state the causes of inflation. A has taken care of the fifth one you would have answered, and B, now you have to answer 4 questions in B. That is making all of them altogether 5 questions. We have to look at how to control inflation. We will not be explaining them. We will only mention them. But in our next lesson, we have to pick them one after the other to explain them so that it will help you very well in your exams to know how to explain them and to know the words that you use and the way you go about it. How do we control inflation? We have surplus budget. The use of surplus budget, we have increase in taxation. 3, we have modern technology. 4, we have increase in bank rates. 5, we have use of open market operation. And 6, we have price control. And we still have economic effects of inflation. All these come in your exam, depending on how the examiner wants to put it. So I will still want us to pick them one after the other and explain them so that you will know how you should do it in your examination. Well, let us just mention them the way they are. Economic effects of inflation. 1 is high profit during inflation. High profit is made by the producers make high profit. 2, reduction in value of money because of inflation. Money doesn't have value during inflation. The value of money reduces. 3, fixed income earners lose. Those that take fixed income, that are salary earners, that are paid the same thing every month, during inflation they lose. 4, fall in standard of living. Standard of living will fall because what you used to buy for 10 naira before, now you buy it at 60 naira, so standard of living will fall. 5, debtors gain. Those that are borrow money, they will gain. Because when they borrow that money may buy 50 naira something. But today, that money they borrow, now, the worth of what it will buy now may be about 200 naira or 300 naira. 7, discourages savings. The high cost of goods and services will not allow you to save. 6, creditors lose. The creditor, that's the people that borrow money to people, they lose because that money they have borrowed out is no longer the same value. When they borrowed 50 naira, and 50 naira can buy a loaf of bread of 50 naira, that loaf of bread of 50 naira during inflation will now cost about 300 naira. So they have lost. Their 50 naira may not have value any longer. 7, it discourages savings. People will no longer save because of high cost of goods and services. They will be struggling to buy things. Then 8, causes of deficit balance of, it causes deficit balance of payment. There will be deficit balance of payment. 9 says discourages investment. So when we come in the next lesson, we explain them very well, the way you understand them. Because of our time, I will run over what I have taught you before, but we no longer go to assignment. But when we come to next lesson and we define all this, we explain all these things very well, then you can now give you assignments. I told you in the beginning we talked about inflation itself. We defined inflation. I told you that inflation is the continuous rise in the prices of goods and their services. A continuous rise in the prices of goods and their services. We can also say that inflation means too much money pursuing too few goods. When there is too much money in circulation, but the goods and services in circulation are not enough to augment for the demand. Then I equally say that there are these ways of measuring inflation. I said one is GDP index. GDP, that is the value of goods and services that are produced in a particular country at a given period of time. You use it and measure inflation. The second one is the wholesale index, meaning the cost of production. Increase in the cost of production, that is what you use. The price of equipment that are used in production, like equipment, machine, and raw materials, you can use it to measure inflation. While 3 is consumer price index, which is actually the main determinant of level of inflation because it measures the prices of consumer goods and services. I also talked to you about types of inflation. We talked about ordinary inflation, We said it's an intermittent, slow rise in the prices of goods and services caused by increase in the volume of money in circulation. We talked about persistent. We said that persistent is the continuous rise in the price of goods and services owing to the circulation of money. There is a larger circulation of money in the economy than you have goods and services. The money in the economy is more than the available goods and services, and that will make inflation to be very high. We talked about the persistent inflation is divided into following. We have demand pull inflation. We have we say that this is caused by the demand, actual demand of people. When demand exceeds supply of goods and services, then inflation will go up. We talked about cost pull inflation. We say that this is when the rise in prices of goods and services increase because of the cost of production. And we talked about hyperinflation. And this hyperinflation or galloping inflation is caused when prices of goods and services skyrocket to unimaginable height because of a war or deficit budgeting. With this, I have to conclude this lesson, hoping to see you next time so that we can discuss those items that I've listed. My name remains Obi Ifeanyi, and you can get me on this number. Either you can call me or you send your message through WhatsApp. I'll always be there to attend to you. 080-350-328-31. I repeat the number again, 080-350-328-31. You are welcome. Stay safe, wash your hands, coronavirus is real, and be healthy for this country. And remember, the economy of this country is at our hands. Thank you and God bless you.